Welcome to the User Interface video series. This tutorial describes the particle tracking functionality available for the GeoStudio mass transfer products. In GeoStudio, particle tracking can be used to examine the movement of a particle of mass in a transient analysis. Previously, particle tracking was only available in CTRAN W. However, it is now available in SEEP W, AIR W, and CTRAN W. A particle's velocity is determined given the computed water or air flux and the inputted soil porosity or the saturated volumetric water content. Thus, mass particle movement is equivalent to advection-only transport without any mechanical dispersion. Transport of this nature is often called plug flow in the hydrogeology literature. This GeoStudio analysis considers the movement of water from a pond placed beside a slope, given an initial water level of 4 meters throughout the domain. The particle tracking functionality can be used to trace a molecule of water or a dissolved substance moving from the pond and into the domain over time. To utilize the particle tracking functionality, we must first add particles to the domain. To do so, go to Draw Particles and click on the position in the domain where you wish the particle to begin at. I will add particles at several points along the pond perimeter. The position of the particles is determined for each time step of a transient analysis. We may view the particles' movement over time by clicking through the time steps in the Result Times window. More information is provided under View Particle Information. When we click on one of the particles, this dialog displays the total travel time, the particle coordinates, the total distance traveled over this time, and the corresponding average speed, which is equal to the travel distance over time. In summary, the particle tracking functionality has been expanded to all mass transfer products. Particles may be easily added to the model domain. Particle tracking provides information on a particle's position, travel distance, travel time, and corresponding average speed for each time step, given the water or air flux and soil porosity. For more information on GeoStudio and its features, please look at the example files and other tutorial videos on the GeoSlope website. Thank you for watching.